I'm Andrew Wasson from Creative Guitar Studio. Thanks for joining me for another one of my guitar lessons. This time around, we're going to take a look at the direction of rhythm guitar, and in specific, the idea of creating more of a smooth, funky blues sound in your guitar playing. Now, this is a really cool question for a topic in the lesson, and it was sent in from James. He's out in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. He wrote in saying, I'm a blues fan. I like Luther Allison, Steve Cropper, and Earl Hooker for their funky blues sound. My problem is that I can't develop that smooth 16th note rhythm playing. I think I need a simple pop music approach to start from. Is there a pop music sound where I can start at and then move on to funky blues? I'd sure like to learn smooth, funky blues playing. From James in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, USA. Well, hey, thanks for writing in, James. When that funky blues sound gets smoothed out, we're generally noticing that the 16th note is really taking center stage with the groove. Plus, we'll also generally have a slightly different order and sequence to the structure of the typical blues progression. While some songs will stick fairly close to the 12-bar blues format, other harmonic ideas will often get included, and these are going to range from, you know, shifts in quality, such as a typical dominant seventh chord changing to a major or a minor triad, or even to different seventh chords. Plus, we might even find other chords appear as well, like extended or altered chords. So, you know, all this into effect is going to mean that in this lesson, I want to organize some exercises starting with just getting that funky blues style. We're going to begin from more of a basic pop music standpoint, but we'll progress on to adding in blues scale ideas, fills, runs, extended and altered chords, as well as doing a string snap technique, getting that pop sound off your guitar string that's really happening in this style quite a lot. So let's not waste any time. We'll zoom in on the neck and get started. Well, I want to begin with a couple of examples in more of the pop genre that focus on the feel of the 16th note, and in particular the strum pattern and the groove of the 16th. In example number 1A, I've put together a strumming study that not only applies steady 16th notes across the measures, but that also uses just small triad shapes. And we're just going to move those along the neck. Now, what's also going to do is have the chord segments only located on the upper three strings, and all the 16th note work is going to be fairly steady. On the first three measures, it's just exclusively 16ths on the first and the third beats. So the chord changes are going to go like this. We're going to have G major moving over to a G7, which is basically part of the G dominant seventh chord that we'd have if we played it with the bass note there on the fourth string, fifth fret, except we're going to exclude that note, and we're just going to go with the upper tones. Then we're going to move down the neck a little bit, have E minor triad, and then E flat major coming up the neck to F, and then the G resolving there at the seventh position. So altogether, example number 1A sounds like this. Now, in example number 1B, what we're going to do next is we're going to expand a part on the part from example number 1A, and we're going to add in some straightforward sounding passing lines that fill up the space of each measure after the harmony has been established. Now, in an effort to keep all this quite simple, I'm only going to have the melodic filler lines added in the first two measures. The first filler line is more pentatonic scale oriented, but in order to cover that G7 sound, we're going to be working a little bit more from the mixolydian scale ideas. So what's going to happen is off of the first measure, we're going to have that triad come in as normal, as a 16th note groove, and then we're going to have a filler line out of a G pentatonic. So here it is again. Sorry. That's better. Okay, then the next part is the G7. And then we're going to move through the mixolydian mode. So we have that run down the mixolydian scale like that. Then we're going to move into E minor. And then E flat. And then we're going to come up the neck here to the seventh position again for the G major. And then build up across E flat, F, and then back. So here it is all together now. Thank you. can tell when you're putting that all together, it's a really interesting sound, but you know, it still kind of sounds more like pop music rather than any kind of funky blues. So there's a bit of that funky edge there with those 16th notes, but right now it's fairly pop oriented. So what we're going to do next is we're going to come back in a second and we're going to convert the pop music sound into more of a funky blues sound. Well, next an example too, we're going to start out by bringing in more of that blues sound with melodic lines pulled out of the pentatonic scale. Now the blues sound includes major and minor ideas with the addition of a lowered third for the major sounds against the major third and a diminished fifth that'll function against perfect fifth intervals in that minor color. So, you know, overall the color of the phrases really begins to change with respect to all these other ideas entering into the mix with the major and minor, you know, tonalities. So what we're going to do in example number two is we're going to take a very similar idea running through the same chord changes that we had in example number one. Starting off with that G chord, so it's going to be the 16th note groove there, and then we're going to do some bends on that. Major and minor third coming in on that one, and then on the G7 chord, we're going to have some mixolydian mode. Then when we head into the E minor sound, we're going to cover E minor pentatonic, and then we're going to head into the E flat sound when we get to that chord, and we're going to have major pentatonic with flat third. And come back around again into the G natural when the G major chord shows up once again. So altogether, the whole phrase goes like this. Now I do have the background chords set up in the loop pedal, so I'd like to fire that up and give you a chance to hear how all this continues along, you know, with especially in the third and fourth measures when we have more of the licks showing up rather than any chord punches starting the measures off. So here we go. Here's the whole thing again from example number two, but with the backing track in it. Well, now that we've had a chance to convert sounds from pop and take them more into a blues direction, let's have another look into the 16th note grooves with a funky blues, almost like Steve Cropper soul funk style, a jam that pushes through the dominant sevenths of going through a 1-4-5 set of changes. But we're going to apply them using smaller 3-note triads, and in doing this, we're going to have a nice funky blues approach, but we're also going to have some filler tones along the way that'll pull everything together on the upper register and give it a little bit more melodic side to the riff. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to start off, if you look at your handout under example 3, you'll see there's a 16th note and it starts with a groove and it starts with a slide just like that. So it's 16th note feel but starts with a slide into that ninth position. Then for an A chord coming in, we're going to bounce off D and we're going to have the A come off that, and then we're going to have A7 with some passing tones on the third string just going A7, A6, A major, and then heading into the seventh position, we'll have a bar there for a D major-ish kind of sound, adding in the flat 7 on top on the 8th fret first string, and then we'll have some inside tones there, adding still a more dominant 7th color, and then having an A come in on an A7th chord, adding an A13, and then an E dominant 9. So there's a lot of extensions that are happening here. It's a very cool kind of sound. Let me put it all together for you here, just give you a good idea how it fits all, you know, back to back. So that's the first half, and then the second half. Okay, here it is again. You can tell how it all blends together. It has a really neat sound, a lot of movement there, and some passing tones coming around the chords as well. Very cool. I'll play one more time for you. Well, for my last example, I wanted to bring in another funky blues idea. This one is a little different because it doesn't apply the busy 16th note groove like we've seen in the previous examples. However, it does apply a popular funky blues effect that's generally referred to as a string snap. Now, this is a really popular sound in funk songs and a definite must-know technique, I think, for guitar players. So, you know, it's really straightforward to produce. All you really do is you are producing a variation on hybrid picking. And instead of just plucking the upper guitar string, you know, normally, what you're going to do is you're going to snap it by simply applying a little bit more force at it. So I'm using my middle finger in this case. I'm snapping the string. I'm creating that pop sound, that snap sound off of it. And what I've got together here in example four to get you to try is it's just going to go through minor blues, 1-4-5 minor blues in the key of E minor, A, and then B, and then back to that E again. Now, I'm going to spice it up a bit, of course, because we are playing funky blues. We're trying to make it a little bit more grooving. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have an E minor 7 with a walking line, and I'm going to put the pops in there, the string snaps in there. So we'll have that going on. And then we're going to move down to A minor 7. But then I'm going to have some more walking lines with some string pops. And then we're going to go across B minor 11. Just really give it a groovy sound. And then we're going to do a guitar lick that's going to have some coverage around a sound of a B7 augmented, basically. But around that lick, I'm going to get some string pops going on. All right, so I'll put all that together, give you a chance to hear how example number four sounds. So you can hear in there when you're getting the string pops and the biggest, I guess, the drawback to it here is it's uneven. And it's something that you really got to watch if you're recording in the studio because you have very different spikes to the attack. And sometimes the attacks will come out one way, another way. It's almost like you don't know how they're going to, you know, really be in their dynamic sense. But, you know, you just it's really a great thing live because live it doesn't matter too much. I mean, you're just, you know, the sound is usually nice and loud. And however you attack it is, you know, just how it's going to happen. But, you know, for us in the studio, it's a lot different. I mean, we're going to have to maybe really balance out all those attacks, make sure they're perfect. It may require you recording things over and over again till you're happy with that snap sound. So experiment with it. You know, as you learn a part and get better at the part, it'll feel more comfortable to you. And hopefully, you know, as you get into recording the sounds that they bounce out really nice for you. So anyway, that's the last example. And from here on out, you just got to practice all these ideas. I know it's a lot of stuff, but if you can integrate it into your playing, it's going to really be cool for your style and your sound, especially if you really dig this funky blues idea. Well, whatever direction you decide to take playing funky blues in, you're going to need to understand a few specific rhythm guitar abilities and a few rhythm guitar techniques as well. Learning rhythm parts by guitarists in this style, like maybe Albert Collins or Freddie King, will certainly help. But also be sure to check out some of the smooth jazz players. They're really into this sound as well. Guys like maybe Larry Carlton or even Norman Brown have a great sound and great ways that they employ these ideas in their music, and they, you know, shouldn't be overlooked. So start out by just nailing those 16th note grooves and then try working in filler licks, bring in the blues scale, especially, you know, the pentatonic sounds are super important here. Also try adding different chords, extended chords like the 9th and the 13th are really strong, as well as even some others if you're dealing in minor, maybe minor 11 and so forth. And also try bringing in that hybrid picked string snapping sound. That's a great idea to add in to really bring the color out of this funky blues style. So anyway, that's about all time I have for today. Once again, I want to say thanks for watching. Have fun working on all this stuff. You can download the handout and an MP3 jam track for this video over at my website at andrewwasson.com. You can follow me on Twitter and you can like me on Facebook and subscribe to my other guitar blog YouTube channel. That's a great channel. There's new videos coming out there every Sunday, as well as I got that micro lesson series that I'm running on there from Monday to Thursday. Thursday. It's a new guitar lick or a riff or a finger picking pattern. You can learn pretty much every one of those days, and the videos are short and they have on-screen tabs, so they're real easy to grab onto. Anyway, the links are all in the description box for this stuff. Take care, everyone, and I will see you next time. Bye for now.